Hi. I just said, don't sit here. Think what you can do. What you can do to improve your reality, to improve your neighborhood, to improve your country. Here I have a solution. I have an idea. As you might remember, on Sunday at the DLD All-Stars opening, we heard about a brave and very courageous new vision for Europe from European Commission President Ursula von der Leyen, the new European Bauhaus. It's also a call for action. In case you missed the session, you can already find it on our YouTube channel. The new European Bauhaus is an interdisciplinary initiative that plans to bring Europe's Green Deal to our living places, to our neighborhoods, to our cities, to us. It's my great pleasure to host this next conversation between two eminent leaders who are key to bringing this interesting, outstanding new European initiative, Bauhaus initiative, on the road. Please welcome Maria Gabriel, European Commissioner for Innovation, Research, Culture, Education and Youth. She is an interdisciplinary thinker who knows about the huge potential that lies in the European innovation ecosystems, as well as in our continent's cultural richness and diversity. She's an evangelist for Europe and for the innovation, power of innovation in Europe. Commissioner Gabriel will be joined by my good friend and DLD curator, art curator, beside many other functions. He is doing so much for all of us in the art world and the cultural world, not only art curator for DLD. He is the artistic director for the Serpentine Galleries. He is the friend of many artists. He is the promoter of a rich cultural life we have to live. Hans Ulrich is a firm believer in the important role that artists play in the necessary systemic change of our world towards a greener and more inclusive future. My two friends, the floor is yours.
Thank you so much, Steffi, and such a great pleasure, Maria, to finally meet, because Steffi wanted to bring us together for such a long time. And I spoke last year at DLD about the necessity for democratic and decentralized new transnational projects, wondering how that could also relate actually to Roosevelt's New Deal, being of course aware that this is a very different time, so we need new models. But still, the idea of this New Deal supported so many artists, had actually, as Roosevelt said, to do with bold and persistent experimentation. So I'm obviously very curious to know more about this idea of a new European Bauhaus, and maybe to begin with the beginning and ask you a little bit to tell us how it will be built, how it will be moderated, and how it will be maintained.
Well, first of all, thank you very much, Steffi. Thank you, dear Hans. It's a great pleasure for me to be together with you again to discuss about our vision for Europe, vision for the world, and always based on values, creativity, and richness of our cultural diversity. So thank you very much again for this opportunity. I will start immediately saying that what is the new European Bauhaus in one sentence? It's a cultural, environmental and economic project, because it has the ambition to make our Green Deal a cultural, human-centered, positive and tangible experience. And I think that even if we take as example that the motto born a century ago was form follows function, we could say that this one could be necessary, can be beautiful, and form follow planet. So this initiative aims at launching exactly this, a movement of co-design, including three main aspects: sustainability, aesthetics, and inclusion. And what we would like to see with the new European Bauhaus, it's of course to see how we can articulate these three areas in an innovative way. Because for sure, the COVID-19 showed us that the world is interconnected, and we need here new thinkings coming from breaking silos, and the challenges at the same time are so multifaced and complex that we need a holistic view and we need to work together. And that's why we have now the new European Bauhaus in order to bring the European Green Deal to life. And our common objective is, of course, to create a better tomorrow for all of us. But that means that first we need to mobilize all societal actors. And I very much insist on this, because the new European Bauhaus really wants to reach our youth, artists, activists, engineers, designers, students, scientists, and everyone. Because what we would like to see is how we can facilitate the exchange of knowledge, ideas, and needs between these actors to empower our communities to create a true interdisciplinary project. And I think that here we need to say very clearly, beyond architecture and design, the entire cultural sector, including galleries such as yours, Hans, has a particular role to play. Because allow me here to ask just some question: who else can better articulate questions and visions for our future living together? Who else can better articulate, on one side, the pulse of our societies, our aspirations, and on the other, the shaping of our places and our interactions? So that's why for me it's so important that cultural and creative sectors should stay very mobilized. We have some very encouraging signs. There is already a lot of candidates to become partners of this initiative. But where we are actually, we are in this listening mode, in a co-design process, and that's why we need the contribution of everyone.
Now, in a wonderful book, actually, called Dub, Alexis Pauling-Gams talks about this moment we have now, this opportunity as a species, being in touch with each other to unlearn and relearn our patterns of thinking and storytelling in a way that allows us actually to be in communion with our environment, as opposed to a separation from the environment. And if you want to solve that, of course, we need to bring all the disciplines together, as you said. And that means, of course, that artists need a seat at the table where decisions are being made. And it's very interesting because in the 60s, actually 70s, John Latham and Barbara Stevini in England had this project called Artist Placement Group. And they wanted to kind of bring artists into political processes. They wanted to bring artists on boards of companies. They felt artists need to be involved in all aspects of society. So I was wondering, it's obviously great to hear that you give artists an important role in the future of Europe. I would like to hear more how you're gonna do that.
Well, to be very honest, I strongly support this idea behind this artist placement group, because artists have really a real value in our policies. And today we are facing challenges that are so much complex and interlinked in our societies that they are becoming more and more evident that we need to address this complexity. And that's why artists are so important, because they are giving us new perspectives. They really refresh our minds. And we already have some very good examples how artists participate in some of our decision-making policy processes, and results are here. So I can only very much welcome these kind of initiatives. Allow me just here to be very pragmatic, because 1 month ago, we launched our website. And actually, that is the single entry point where what we are doing, we are really now listening to the different stakeholders, what are their ideas, how they would like to engage in a longer term with this initiative. Why this is important? Because all those that will express their ideas for debates, for initiatives, for projects, and will be there to stay mobilized for long-term period, will be named partners of New European Bauhaus. And with these partners, what we would like to see is to build a community that after will really build bridges between local realities and the different innovations, between good practices and new fresh ideas. And that's exactly what I would like to see now, that we'll have a strong mobilization of the community of culture and creative sectors, but in the same time, really to help them to facilitate our work, how we can integrate the creativity of the art world into our realities. And we very, very much count on their involvement.
Thank you so much. And now, obviously, we've all been looking at these graphs Scott Galloway showed us before, and Steffi was saying how important it is to do something. And of course, also to do something for a young generation of emerging practitioners who are particularly affected by the COVID crisis. And I know that in your work, that has always played a very central role, no? The initiatives related to young people. You've also set up European information centers in Bulgaria. So I was very curious, given the fact that this is so important for your work, how this is going to be addressed in the new European Bauhaus, this new generation?
Well, I must say that this question is very important for me. And that's why since the beginning, I paid a lot of attention that first, young people are including in this very first phase of the co-design process. And actually, when we started to discuss the list of the first experts with whom we'll start the brainstorming, try to shape the process, try really to identify what are the challenges and what are the possible solutions, they were included since the beginning. And I'm very proud that we have representatives from Youth Forum. Now we need to continue to mobilize our young people and not to stay in the usual networks, not to stay in the Brussels bubble. That's why I very much count on our work with the Committee of the Regions, because there is here a huge channel of communication. Of course, I will use the other instruments in my portfolio, because I'm a very lucky commissioner. I have innovation, and who else that young people can innovate? I have culture with me, and there is a lot of engagement of young people in this field. And of course, I have education, because we need here to adopt a real holistic approach. We need to see how the different driving forces in all our regions, with the different categories of young people coming from different regions and different member states, can engage. And that's actually our intention. Of course, we have already some very good traditions with Creative Europe program, with Erasmus Plus program. So my intention now is really to use already the existing networks, and that's very positive. We already started to see that the interest is growing and growing. But on the other side, to use some new opportunities, especially with digital technologies, with innovation, and with some of the novelties in our programs like Erasmus Plus and Creative Europe. So definitely here we need to continue. It's a daily effort. And that's what I would like to see, that it's not only an announcement effect where we say, we would like to listen to the voices of young people. What is important for me is after to involve them in projects, to give them the possibility to show us that their engagement, it's not only an ideas. They are able to use their potential in order to provide us solutions. That's what young people are looking for, I think, and that's what I would like to support.
And that, of course, was so interesting about the Roosevelt Initiative, because tens of thousands of young emerging artists and practitioners really got a beginning. If it's, you know, Jacob Lawrence or Mark Roscoe or Alice Neal, all these extraordinary artists who became so important afterwards in the 40s, 50s, 60s, de Kooning, they could Lee Krasner, they could never have started their work without the support really from the New Deal projects at the beginning. So I was wondering, because you did announce that there would be some prizes and grants, I think 10 prizes for existing projects. I was wondering, because of course, it will need a lot of support, particularly given the extreme crisis there is and how difficult it is for many artists now. How will this young generation be supported?
Well, when we talk about the creation of this new European prize, I must say that for this first year edition, and we want to do that by the end of summer, that will be for already existing projects. What we'd like to see is that we have already good projects with the three main aspects, inclusion, aesthetics, and sustainability. And I think that we have a lot of different examples. What we need to do is to define the 10 categories. And I think that here, that's why we have this design phase, that we need to continue to listen to our people and to our stakeholders. What, for example, my question is, what that should be, these 10 categories. Because when we think about new European Bauhaus, it's not only about our environment, it's not only about the energy efficiency of our buildings, it's about our daily life, it's about accessibility, it's about affordability, it's about our art to live together. So I think that what we have to see the next few months is how this scope of the initiative will evolve. And what is good is that for me, it's up to our stakeholders, to young people, to creators, to entrepreneurs, to architects, to design and to define this content. Of course, for the next year, that will be more than clear that the prize this time will support solutions, innovative projects that need to be realized in order to bring more people closer to this concept, to engage with more people, and to show simply that what we try to do is for the benefits of all of us. That's for me the main ambition of our initiative with the New European Bauhaus, because if you'd like really to show to all our citizens that the European Green Deal, that's their own project, we need before to bring with the New European Bauhaus concrete benefits for all of them.
Now, also, I love this idea of listening. The poet Etel Adnan was actually saying the other day, we need to learn to listen again. And listening is one of the most important things for the 21st century. We're going to have later, actually, this afternoon, Tino Segal, the artist. And he once said, you know, the 20th century was a lot about manifestos. And the 21st century has maybe as much to do with listening as with manifestos. And that, of course, shows us that it's a very different moment. And we spoke the other day, you know, and you said that maybe we need neologisms, we need new words, we shouldn't maybe go back to old models in this time. And that, of course, refers to the New Deal. So we might not call it the New Deal, but something else. But it, of course, also refers to the notion of the Bauhaus, which has been so far used, but is, of course, a very 20th century notion. So I was wondering, in this sort of bottom-up process of listening, could there also be a new language emerging that is maybe called something else?
Well, we need to preserve the bottom-up approach, because that will be our main argument to convince more people that we are here not only to listen to them, but to build things and our future together with all of them. So that's why, for me, the New European Bauhaus is about how we can empower our citizens really to take the opportunity of the European Green Deal. Remember, it's our new growth strategy, and it is at the same time a motor and compass of our recovery. So I like very much these two words, because that means that on one side we have similarities with different initiatives, but on the other side we need to continue to think about what is unique, what is really unique with this initiative. And I think that here we can make differences with what already existed and what we would like to see. Because for us, it's not a one-off initiative. It's, again, as I already said it, cultural, environmental, and economic project. And that means that we should continue to evolve together with all the stakeholders. And that's why, for me, that's now the good time to address some of the main challenges, because the initiative is really all-encompassing, but we need to look at different aspects. That's why, for me, for example, there is a difference with the New Deal in the time of Roosevelt, because, okay, the Works Progress Administration in the Roosevelt's New Deal was a dedicated agency for carrying out public works. The New European Bauhaus does not attempt to perform the same role. The New European Bauhaus is a holistic initiative aiming at societal changes. And for me, here, there is a particularly important role to play for the innovation, and because we'll need that. Innovation will be there to help us how we can reimagine our spaces where we are living, how we are interacting with another, and how we just defend our own values. So I think that definitely the New European Bauhaus, it's a driver for change, but that means that we need here to preserve our European mark in this initiative, our values, our principles, and at the same time to propose solutions for these challenges that people are waiting for that.
Thank you so much. I know we are almost out of time, and I hope, as Steffi said, that this is the first conversation and that we can continue this dialogue, because there would be so many other aspects to be discussed. I mean, it's of course also so important in terms of the environmental crisis that all the disciplines come together. It's about the invention of the future of the city, as we discussed in our call a few days ago, and also thinking about the future of the cities differently than the only privately driven smart cities which are being proposed, and come up with a reinvention of public space. I know, Steffi, we are out of time, but I have to ask one very last question, which is the only recurrent question in all my conversation. And it's the conversation, it's actually the question about the unrealized project. Because we know a lot about architects' unrealized projects and dreams because they publish them, but we know very little about all other practitioners' unrealized projects. And I was wondering about your unrealized project, about your dream for Europe.
Well, first, if I may say two things, because I really think that definitely we have to have other discussions, because when we talk about our smart cities as a former digital commissioner, as now Steffi with our innovation ecosystem approach, we have to think and to talk about this. So I will be very glad. The other, when we talk about unrealized project, I think that it's really time to change our mind on this. Every unrealized project is an experience. That's not a failure. We really need to encourage people to change their mind about this. And finally, what is my dream for Europe, even with this project and with all the different things that I'm doing? If I may, I will use one word in French, that Europe should always be at the rendezvous of the history. Because we have the capacities, the experience, the extraordinary cultural diversity, richness for that. But it's time really to act, not only to listen, not only to have declarations, but to act together with everyone. No one should be left behind. Think out of the box, and we have the assets to do it.
What a wonderful sentence. What a wonderful vision. Maria, Commissioner Gabriel, Hans Ulrich, this was a really important talk. I'm very happy to brought you together. But let's make it a kickoff. This is the kickoff. I hope it's the beginning of many other conversations between Hans Ulrich and you, Maria Gabriel, maybe a little bit of me too. We should help you in this amazing initiative, New Bauhaus. We should work together. We should find the creativity of Europe, of the young Europe, of the artists' Europe. We should really, it's another call for action. I'm very glad that the two of you spoke. See you soon.
Thank you so
Thank
much.
You. Thank
Thanks
you.
A lot. See you soon. Thank you.
See you soon. Bye.